In this lecture of analog communication, we will understand the importance of the modulation index in the amplitude modulation. According to the previous lecture, if the modulating signal or message signal Mt is equal to Am cos omega mt or Am cos 2 pi fmt and the carrier signal Ct is equal to Ac cos omega ct or Ac cos 2 pi fct, then the amplitude modulated signal St is equal to Ac plus mt into cos 2 pi fct, which comes down to ST is equal to AC into 1 plus K cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT, where K is defined as the modulation index. Modulation index is the level of modulation which a carrier undergoes in the time of modulation. Modulation index can be written as K is equal to AM by AC. We have also seen that the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal A maximum is equal to AC plus AM and the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal A minimum is equal to AC minus AM. So the amplitude of the message signal AM is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by 2 and the amplitude of the carrier signal AC is equal to A maximum plus A minimum divided by 2. According to these, modulation index can be written as K is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum. Depending on the value of the modulation index K, if K is less than 1, then the modulated wave has under modulation. If K is equal to 1, then the modulated wave has perfect modulation. If K is greater than 1, then the modulated wave has over modulation. Now we'll understand what is under, over and perfect modulation. Now, amplitude modulated signal can be given by ST is equal to AC into 1 plus K into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT, where K is the modulation index. For undermodulation, condition for the undermodulated wave is K is less than 1. Now, let's say K is equal to 0.5. Again, from the definition of the modulation index, K is equal to AM by AC or 0.5 into AC is equal to AM. We can also say that K is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum or 0.5 is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum. From where we can write 0.5 into A maximum plus 0.5 into A minimum is equal to A maximum minus A minimum, which can be written as 1.5 into A minimum is equal to 0.5 into A maximum, which can be simplified as 3 into A minimum is equal to A maximum. So the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is equal to AC plus 0.5 into AC or 1.5 into AC, where AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal. And the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal A minimum is equal to AC minus AM, which is equal to AC minus 0.5 into AC, which is equal to 0.5 AC. Again, AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal. For the perfect modulation, condition for the perfectly modulated wave is K is equal to 1. Again, from the definition of modulation index, K is equal to AM by AC. So we can write AC is equal to AM. Then the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal, A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is equal to AC plus AC or 2 into AC. And the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal A minimum is equal to AC minus AM or A minimum is equal to AC minus AC, which is equal to 0. Here AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal. For overmodulation, condition for the overmodulated wave is modulation index K is greater than 1. Let's say modulation index K is equal to 1.5. Then again, from the definition of the modulation index, K is equal to AM by AC or 1.5 into AC is equal to AM. Again, we can write 1.5 is equal to A maximum minus A minimum divided by A maximum plus A minimum. After cross multiplication, it can be written as 1.5 into A maximum plus 1.5 into A minimum is equal to A maximum minus A minimum, which can be written as 2.5 into A minimum is equal to minus 0.5 into A maximum, which can be simplified as minus 5 into A minimum is equal to A maximum. So the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is equal to AC plus 1.5 into AC or 2.5 into AC, and minimum amplitude of the modulated signal A minimum is equal to AC minus AM or A minimum is equal to AC minus 1.5 into AC, which is equal to minus 0.5 into AC. We will try to understand these three types of modulation by using MATLAB. We will plot the message signal and the carrier signal and the amplitude of the modulated signal for the different values of the modulation index K, and we will see how undermodulated, perfectly modulated and overmodulated wave looks like, and the minimum and the maximum amplitude of the modulated signals. If we consider undermodulated wave where modulation index K is equal to 0.5, then it looks like this. Let's say amplitude of the message signal is equal to 10 and the amplitude of the carrier signal can be figured out by using modulation index and the amplitude of the message signal, which is equal to 10 by 0.5, which is equal to 20. So the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal in the case of undermodulated wave is equal to 1.5 into AC, where AC is the amplitude of the carrier signal, or A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is equal to 30, and the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal is equal to 0.5 into AC, or A minimum is equal to AC minus AM, is equal to 10. Here maximum amplitude will be 3 times the minimum amplitude. Let us see the graphical plottings of the message signal, carrier signal and the modulated signal. This is the message signal, this is the carrier signal, and this is the modulated signal in the case of the under modulation. As you can see, amplitude modulated wave has an envelope and this is an under modulated wave. Here we can see that minimum amplitude is 10 and it rises to the maximum amplitude of 30, which is 3 times the minimum amplitude, then it again goes down to the minimum amplitude of 10. For the perfect modulation, modulated wave has a modulation index of k is equal to 1. Then the amplitude modulated wave looks like this. Again, the amplitude of the message signal is equal to 10, and so the amplitude of the carrier signal is equal to AM by K, which is also equal to 10. The maximum amplitude of the modulated signal is equal to 2 into AC, or A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is 2 into 10 or 20, and the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal is equal to 0. And this is a perfectly modulated wave having no distortion. Here the signal falls to 0 at this point, rises to twice the value at this point, then again goes back to 0. If we consider an overmodulated wave where modulation index k is greater than 1, then the amplitude modulated wave will have distortion. Here the amplitude of the message signal is equal to 10. In this case, modulation index k is equal to 1.5. Now the amplitude of the carrier signal is equal to 10 by 1.5, which is equal to 6.67. So the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal in the case of the overmodulated wave is equal to 2.5 into amplitude of the carrier signal or AC, or 2.5 into 6.67, or A maximum is equal to AC plus AM, which is equivalent to 16.675. And the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal is equal to minus 0.5 into AC, or A minimum is equal to AC minus AM, which is equal to minus 3.385. Here, as we can see, the minimum amplitude of the modulated signal is equal to 3.385 and it rises to the maximum amplitude of the 16.67. Here, the value of modulation index increases over 1, and due to this, carrier signal experiences a 180 degree phase reversal, which causes additional sidebands, hence the modulated wave gets distorted. Such overmodulated wave causes interference which cannot be eliminated. That's all for this lecture. If you want the following MATLAB code, then subscribe to my channel. If this lecture receives 20 likes, then I will provide the MATLAB code in the description box. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.